Let's work through a few examples of sigma notation and some formulas. Okay, so the first example, number one here, is the sum from k equals 1 to 53 of k. Okay, so as I read that, I've kind of said what this notation means, but this symbol that sort of looks like an E maybe is called a sigma. And then you notice we have a subscript and a superscript. And then we have k, which in this case is what we're actually summing. So if I were to do this by hand, what this would be is I would be plugging in these values from 1 to 53 for k and summing them up. So this would be like 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus so on all the way up to 53. Now, of course, I could do that by hand and get the answer, but the point of these sum formulas that we just looked at is to have a more efficient way of calculating large sums like these. So let me write down the relevant formula here. So we just saw that the sum from 1 to n of k is n times n plus 1 over 2. So let's apply that formula to our problem that we have. So if you kind of line up our problem with the formula, our n is 53, right? We're summing from k equals 1 to 53. So I'm just going to plug in to my formula. So this is going to equal 53 times 54 divided by 2. And then if you add that up, or if you put that into your calculator, multiply it out, you get 1,431. Alright, so let's do one that's a little bit more complicated. So we could have something that looks like this. Okay, the sum from k equals 1 to 21 of 2k squared minus 2k minus 5. Okay, so if I were going to do this out by hand, what would I do? Well, I'd start by plugging in k equals 1. I get whatever that value is. Plug in k equals 2, get whatever that value is, and plug in all the numbers all the way up to 21 into this expression, 2k squared minus 2k minus 5. Figure out what that is, and then add up all those values I get. Okay, so that's a lot of work. But once again, we can use the sum formulas that we just saw to calculate an answer to this a little bit more efficiently. So once again, let me write the relevant formulas out to the side. So we see we have a k squared, so we're going to need the formula for k squared. And it's the most messy of the formulas. It looks like this, n times n plus 1 times 2n plus 1 over 6. Okay, and I'll write down the formula for k one more time, the sum of k. So that was n times n plus 1 over 2. And then we also have this constant term. So there's also a formula for the sum of a constant, which we labeled c, and that was c times n. Okay, so let's see if we can apply these formulas. Now what you can do to help yourself out is you can actually split this up in the same way that you would split up a derivative or an integral. So for example, I can pull constants out front, constant multiples, and I can split up these differences. And if I do that, it's going to look like this. So I pull my constant multiple of 2 out front, and then I have the sum of k squared minus another constant multiple of 2, and then I have the sum of k minus the sum of 5. Okay, so I've split this up, and now I can use the appropriate formula on each piece. So on this first piece, then, I have my 2 out front, which I'll keep there for now, and I'm going to use the k squared formula. Now my n in this case is 21, so I want to plug in 21 for n. So I get 21 times 22, 2n plus 1, so 2 times 21 is 42, plus 1 is 43, and that's all over 6. Minus 2 again, and now I need my k formula. So once again, with n equals 21, okay, so this gives me 21 times 22 over 2. Okay, and then minus my formula for a constant is just that constant times n. So this is going to be 5 times 21. Okay, so now we need to calculate these values. If you plug this first one into your calculator, you should get 6,622, assuming I did that correctly, minus, okay, well, this should just give us 21 times 22, right, because the 2's cancel out. So if you actually calculate that, you get 462. Okay, and then minus 5 times 21, which is 105. All right, and if you put this into your calculator as your final answer, you should get 6,055. Okay, so hopefully this gives you a good sense of how to work with something like this. Now, you need to be a little careful. So let me go back up maybe to this original one here that we did. So we summed k from k equals 1 to 53. Now, notice that my formula, my sum formula, specifically starts at k equals 1 and go to n. So you can only use this formula in this form if your k starts at 1. So what do I mean by that? So what if I had instead the sum from k equals 3 to 53 of k? So I can't use this formula, or I should say I can't use just this formula to solve this now, right? Because I'm not starting at k equals 1. I can still use a formula, though. I just have to use a little bit of extra thought. So what's happening in this problem as opposed to the original one I did? Well, I'm leaving off those first few terms, right? K is 1 and k equals 2. So what I could actually do in this case is I could use my original answer, which would be the sum of all the 53 terms, but then subtract off the first two terms, which would be plugging in k equals 1 and k equals 2. So in this case, I'd be minus 1 minus 2. Okay, and then so minus 3, so what would that be? 14, 28, I guess. So just be careful in the way you use these formulas and just be thoughtful. But they are very useful formulas, so I would highly recommend memorizing these.